Thank you, Ingrid. Today, I will talk to you about recycling. I will talk to you about what makes a great recycling experience. What do your customers want? And more particularly, I will talk to you about what is your value in providing that great recycling experience to your customers. I want to start by putting recycling into context. Do you know what happened on the 29th of July last year? That was the Earth Overshoot Day. What does that mean? It means the date we have spent all the recurring resources on our planet for a full year. In other words, the date should have been 31st of December if we lived on a sustainable planet in a sustainable way. That actually means we are stealing from next year. We're stealing from future generations. I personally have a daughter and I have a son, and I'm really worried about this development. We need to do something about the situation. This boils down to us using more resources than the planet can sustain. Part of the overshoot problem is plastic and plastic pollution. Much of it comes from the footprint, the carbon footprint of virgin plastic production. So we need to cut down. And no doubt, we're already seeing a demand for change. The consumers, the general public, they see the problem. It's a major focus on this. We see governments coming up with laws and legislations to enforce the reuse of plastics. And we see large brands promising to use a certain percentage of recycled material in their containers. So this helps, but it's not enough. How can we make a real impact on the Earth Overshoot Day? Well, a simple proven solution: we need to move from single use to multiple use. We need to reuse the resources we have already extracted over and over again. We are already doing this together today. So we are doing great, but we need to do more. And what more do we need to do? And where are those values? It all starts with increasing the rate of return. To maximize the rate of return, we want to be able to provide the best possible recycling experience. And what is that? Based on a survey by Fong Institute, Insight in 2018, we can break this down into three main areas: flawless operation, universal access. Whatever system that you use should run all the time. It should accept all containers and always be available. Fairly simple. People also want the knowledge of doing something right. To be able to contribute is a motivating factor. And they want it to be as low effort as possible. Mess-free, no more dirty hands, and fast. That's well and good. That was the theory. But what about real life? The recycling experience does matter. Your consumers care for the environment and they want to do good if you give them the opportunity to do so. This is obvious based on the feedback from our latest machine, the Tomra R1, which is specifically designed to give the best possible recycling experience. People are tagging friends and family to try out a new machine, even tagging other store owners, could you please get one of these? Quotes like, you just pour it in. This is simply genius. Finally, no more messy hands. And retailers love it. With a revolutionary recycling experience, you, as a store owner, can take an active role in fighting the plastic pollution, showing your customers that you care. And even more, the best possible recycling experience will drive revenue and loyalty through increased footfall. So, the statements on loyalty, footfall, and revenue are confirmed by store owners where we have piloted the Tomra R1. We have statements of, to the left, increased volumes in numbers up to a tripling, 200%. In the middle, increased footfall as a result of the best recycling experience, and to the right, loyalty in form of retaining customers in the face of competition. These are quotes from different store owners where we had this piloted. Now, what is the hard values? How can you measure this? For the value of containers, most deposit return systems have some sort of handling compensation. So you'll get something back as being part of the loop, either by the number of objects you return. You might get more if it's compacted. You might get more if you you collect more than you sell. Different ways of doing this in different markets. But all in all, it contributes to revenue. The more you collect, the more you get back. Refund in store. Most consumers will spend their refunds in the store where they do their recycling. In Norway, in 2018, this was measured to 68% as an example. So if the volumes increase, or more precisely, if the refunds increase, your revenue will increase. And then, last but not least, the value of material. If all these promises are to be met, the EU legislation on recyclable content and the promises made by the large brands, there is actually not enough recyclable plastic available today. So we are creating a commodity that will increase its value. So note that receiving more means contributing more into a commodity that is in demand. But now, the real major direct value for you as store owners is customers. And this is independent of how the deposit return system works. This will happen. Where I previously talked about 200% or a tripling of volume, we are here looking at consumer sessions. That means how many times did that machine or the sum of machines in that store, how many times were they used? Before installing in the summer of 2018, the store had a more or less steady state of 6,000, in this particular example, use sessions per month. Then something happens. A significant increase in consumer sessions the month after we installed the machine. So what we see is basically, up to the end of 2019, a 50% increase in consumer sessions. And this is a sliding average, so it grows slowly, but it's actually a quite rapid jump. If we look at the percentage growth, and in this graph, the hard yellow line, I am comparing a month in 2019 with the same month in 2018, because volume varies across the season, so I'm trying to make it even. You can see a significant jump when we installed the machine, and then in 2019, it seems that something happened. It's not so fun anymore. But that's not a fact, because then I'm comparing with a machine that was already there. Which means it's not a hype. This is a permanent change of consumer behavior. So you will retain these customers in your store permanently as a result of this machine. That was an example. But we see the same trend in all 7 pilot stores, offering a revolutionary recycling experience. So my value proposal is, what is the value of 2,500 more customers per month in your store, permanently, contributing with their shopping baskets and with their associated margin? And I'll leave you to calculate that. So I've shown you what makes a great recycling experience. I've explained the value of offering this experience to your customers. And together, we can use this to increase clean loop recycling and do our part to move the Earth Overshoot Day. And the beauty of it, we can do it while making a profit. And with that, I am happy to say that recycling just got more wow. Thank you for listening.